Hey folks, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. Check out the new model I designed. It's an origami ball, but that's not all. It's an origami pumpkin. Still not impressed? Okay, check it out. It is a 3D jack-o'-lantern, and it can even be given teeth. Want to learn how to fold it? Ready, set, here goes. So this model, which can either be round like a pumpkin or cubical like a cube, I folded from a single 10-inch square of Kami, but I colored the white side orange. Alternatively, you could use an orange 10-inch square and color the white side black. But you have to make sure that you use acrylic, because otherwise you'll see the black through the paper. All right, so here goes. Let's begin black side up, so turn over, and let's fold diagonally in half. Try to make really exact folds and crease sharply. Let's unfold and rotate 90 degrees, and let's fold in half diagonally in this direction. We're starting out with a water bomb base. So this is how I like to teach it. You take this corner and fold up to the top and turn over right to left, and let's fold this corner to the top. And now let's rotate and let's open this large pocket. Stick your hand inside there. And now let's push these two corners together. So you push it together and then flatten it, and it is a triangle, otherwise known as a water bomb base. All right, now we're going to divide this edge into eight. So let's fold this corner to this point, right where the crease hits the edge, and unfold and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this point and unfold. And now let's fold this corner to where this crease hits the edge right here. And unfold, and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's rotate and fold this corner to where this crease hits the edge. And now let's rotate and let's fold this corner up so that this edge aligns with this edge. And unfold both flaps and rotate. And now let's fold this corner to this crease and rotate, and let's fold this corner to right here. And rotate. Now let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this edge, and this edge aligns with this edge. And crease sharply. And now let's unfold and unfold these flaps. And now let's turn over and let's do the same thing on this side. So let's rotate and let's fold this corner to the midpoint and unfold and rotate, and let's fold this corner to the midpoint and unfold, and fold this corner to where this crease hits the edge right there. And unfold and rotate, and let's fold this corner to right here. And now we're going to fold this flap up again, so we're going to reverse this crease. So let's first erase it. Just try to put your fingernail on it so that you don't see it. And now let's fold it so that this edge goes to here. And now let's unfold both flaps. Now let's rotate. And now we're going to make the stem. So let's fold this corner to here. and rotate, and let's fold this flap to here, right on the existing crease. And let's open this pocket and squash it down so the crease lands right on the edge underneath. And now let's take this flap and we're going to fold it right on this line here. So hold it and fold it right on that line. And let's extend it all the way to this edge. And let's unfold. Now here's a kind of tricky step. So I'm gonna do this slow, see if you can get it. Let's put your thumb underneath this layer and your index finger on top. And we're going to fold once again on this crease that we just made. And as we do, we're going to squash this down like that. Okay, and let's rotate. And now let's fold this flap up right on this point right there. So it's like that. This edge should align with this edge. And let's rotate and let's fold it back up. And this time we're folding right on this point. Okay. And let's tuck this corner into this pocket. Like that. And here is our stem. Now let's work on the eyes. So let's fold this flap in like this. You can just fold it right over the stem. And let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And let's fold this flap back on the existing crease. This. And rotate. And now let's fold this edge to this edge. And unfold, and let's open this pocket and squash it. And rotate. Now let's fold this flap up like this, even with this bottom edge. This flap is going to be the eyes and the nose. So let's fold it back down so that it sticks down a little bit below this edge, about like this. And just fold the tip up. You can adjust this to taste. If you want smaller eyes, just fold it further down like that. And crease that sharply. And now let's fold this flap back up. And let's tuck these two flaps behind these two edges. One and two. Okay, let's turn over, and now let's fold this corner to the top. And rotate, and let's fold this flap in on the existing crease. And unfold, and we have to reverse this corner, so let's first fold it behind, mountain fold it. Let's unfold, and now let's open the flap and just push it in. So it goes in like that and close it back up. And let's fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this crease. And fold the triangle in half. And now let's unfold this flap and let's tuck it underneath this interior flap. So just wrap it around inside like that and close it back up. Okay, now let's rotate. And now we're going to make the mouth. So let's fold this flap over on this existing crease. And let's fold this flap up so that this edge aligns with this crease. And unfold. And we have to reverse it. So let's first mountain fold it. And valley fold it and mountain fold it. And now let's open this flap and just push it in like that and close it back up. Now let's fold this flap to the right and rotate. And let's fold this edge to here and unfold and open this pocket and squash it. Now let's rotate. Now let's fold this flap up so that these edges hit these two points. So just fold it up like this, and this edge hits that point, and this edge hits this point. And let's rotate. Now this is the mouth, and if you want, you could just very easily just pleat this back and forth right now, and you end up with a toothy mouth. But let's try to make a smiley mouth. So this is what we're gonna do. You just take this corner and you just push it up like that. And the same thing on this side. So you just reach in and you're just pushing this corner up and flattening it. If you can't do it, then just make it however you want. Make the mouth look like a mouth. But I like that look to it. And now let's fold this flap up so that this corner goes to this edge, or however you want, but that's how I like it. So about like that. And now let's pleat this flap. And since we're going with the smile motif, I'm going to pleat it once like this. And the next pleat is going to be below this edge right here. So it'll be about like that. And then make a pleat there. And one more little fold up like that. So you see, this is a curve. And then for just the normal smile, you just take this flap and you unfold it, letting the other pleats swing behind like that. So there's the smile. And then when you want to bring back the teeth, you just refold this flap, letting the teeth swing back into view. So there it is. Okay, so there's the smile. And we're almost ready to blow it up, but we have a couple more things to do. This flap right here is loose. We want to try to lock it in place. So let's open it and take this flap and fold it inside like that. Just jam it in so that the fold locks right here. And close it back up. And let's turn over. And now let's just form the stem, because it's a lot easier to do it when it's flat like this. So what you're gonna do is just pull it out and just shape it to taste, just sculpt it. If you really want a 3D stem, you could open up this pocket and, you know, make it like a stem and then close it back up or something like that. But I think that the cleanest way is just like this. Okay, I think we're pretty much ready to blow it up. So let's separate these two flaps and separate these two flaps. See, my paint is still drying. Okay. And just inflate it through this hole. Here it goes. So there's the Cyclops jack-o'-lantern with sunglasses, or sunglass rather. And now let's bring back the eyes by opening here and fold this flap down on the existing crease. And there is the jack-o'-lantern. And you can leave it like this. I think it kind of looks good like that. Look, even it stands pretty nicely. But you can shape it to taste. If you want, you can make it a cube by just pressing along the existing creases like this. And you can kind of shape it to taste, and there it is, the 3D cubicle Halloween jack-o'-lantern. All right, hope you guys enjoyed folding that, and have a happy Halloween. Ha 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 ha. Yum, 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 yum. All right, see you later. Bye-bye. And you can make it talk. Yum, 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 yum. Or you can make it blink. And one last thing, I'm going to show you how to turn this thing into a cyclops. So what you do is unfold this flap like this and fold the flap down like that. This is going to be the pupil in the eye. And now let's unfold here and let's fold this edge to this crease. So it's like that. And let's fold this edge to here. Make sure it goes all the way. We don't want a line in between. Okay, and that already looks pretty funny looking. Now let's fold this flap up to taste so that you have a Cyclops jack-o'-lantern, just like that. And if you want, you can fold the mouth down a little bit more, but I think it looks good like that. So there you go. All right, happy Halloween. Ciao.